So our concluding piece is the very, very great, most famous symphony just about ever written. Da-ba-ba-ba. Is there anybody here who has not heard that piece? And Beethoven wrote this piece over a course of about 8 years. The first sketches that we know of date from around the year 1800, and the first performance took place on December 22nd, 1808. In between 1800 and 1808, Beethoven rewrote the first movement of this piece, the da-ba-ba-ba part, about 56 different times. There's all these different versions of it. And you can actually go online and listen to some of these different versions. And he kept changing it and all that. It's kind of like if you hired somebody to redo your kitchen, and he does all this stuff and then tears it all out because he's not satisfied, does it again, you know. And that's kind of the way Beethoven worked. He loved to revise things. He loved to keep doing it until he got it just exactly right. And I think that's one of the reasons why his music sounds so inevitable. It just seems so like it could be no other way. It's probably because he tried every other way before he got to it. So the first performance of this piece took place in the a theater in Vienna called Theater an der Wien. Wien is just the German word for Vienna. And it used to be in Beethoven's time that this theater was situated on a river called the Vienna River. And that river no longer is now covered up with cement and you know, high rises and all kinds of stuff. You know, so there's no, if you go to Vienna and you look for this river Vienna, you won't find it. But the theater, part of it is the original. It's still there, but only one of the walls is actually the original structure, you know, from Beethoven's time. The first performance that took place was a concert that was over 4 hours long. Imagine. The reason why the concert was so long was because Beethoven was given the theater for free. But there was just one little tiny catch, there was no heat. And so the audience sat throughout this 4 hour performance, like with their coats on and just freezing to death, you know. And the other thing was that on this concert, it was so long, he did the first performance of his sixth symphony, the first performance of this, the fifth symphony, the first performance of his fourth piano concerto with him as the piano soloist. He did like a whole bunch of opera arias that he'd written, and he did this piece called Choral Fantasy, which is written for piano soloist, orchestra, and chorus, and uses some of the themes that you hear in the Ninth Symphony. So this mammoth concert, oh, by the way, on this concert, if you look at the old program, the Sixth Symphony, the Pastoral Symphony, is called Symphony No. 5. And this one is called Symphony No. 6. So the orchestra for this concert had exactly one rehearsal. Can you guys imagine that? One rehearsal to play something that they'd never heard before and that was revolutionary and so different from anything else, you know. But despite that, the audience of the last piece on the program was this, the Beethoven Fifth. And then despite that, the audience kind of said, this is really weird, but we like it, you know. And the piece pretty soon went, what we would say, it went viral, you know. Pretty soon they were playing it in Stuttgart, Germany, and in London, England. And, you know, within about 20 years, the piece was like being played all over Europe. And it's the bedrock of the symphony orchestra's repertoire today. So here is the very, very great, very, very familiar Beethoven Symphony No. 5.
Thank you. Thank you.